but it's been 6 days since the governor issued a state of emergency for South Carolina. And today, DHEC announced 45 additional cases of the coronavirus. This brings the total to 125 cases in 25 counties. This latest update shows 14 of those new cases are in Richland County, the largest jump in the state.
Can you talk to us about the symptoms, what it looks like when you have a mild case of the coronavirus, and what it looks like when you have a severe case of the disease?
Sure. So most people are going to have symptoms that are very common with a lot of different viruses this time of year, almost similar to the flu. Fever and cough are the most common symptoms that people have, shortness of breath also. Some people have some other, you know, symptoms, runny nose, sore throat, even an upset stomach, but those are much smaller of a percentage of patients. The majority of people, 4 out of 5 people who get infected with this novel coronavirus, will be able to recover at home, will do fine. You know, it'll be like having just a general case of the flu. They'll feel badly for a few days to a week, and they'll be able to care for themselves at home and recover without any issues. That fifth person out of the five is those folks we really worry about. They're the ones that need hospitalization. Some of them end up needing to be put on a ventilator to help them breathe. And of course, the worst cases, unfortunately, you know, pass away. But we know that people who are elderly and people who have other medical problems already are more susceptible to being in that more severe case category. So those are the folks we really are trying to protect, especially in our communities.
Over the next week, 2 weeks, month, are we expecting our numbers to continue to trend up, or are we looking for them to go down?
I think we'll definitely see an increase before we see a decrease. And so I think the people in South Carolina need to realize that these numbers are going up. How fast they go up and how high they go can be very much affected by how much people help each other, how much, you know, they do that social distancing. They stay in their homes and away from other people. You know, they don't go to work when they're sick, that sort of thing.
So we have not seen the worst of it yet in South Carolina?
No, ma'am.
But it appears that as more cases are coming in nationwide, that age range is kind of shifting towards a younger population. What does that look like for us specifically in South Carolina? Are we trending that same way? And if we are, what do you say to the young folks who are watching today?
So nationwide, yes, the data, I mean, is still very early, but it is beginning to look to shift more towards young adults and so forth, that millennial generation, as they say. They're still not the majority of the cases, but there's an increase in that age range. Thankfully, in South Carolina, we still are at a point where we have, you know, not that much data. We don't have too many cases. And so we are not seeing that trend yet here, but we can't say for certain whether we'll see it later if we got more cases or not. Certainly, for that age range, we definitely want to say, I mean, you're not invincible. We know you think you are, but also not only for yourself, because even if you catch it, you may recover without problem, but, you know, for those folks, for your grandparents or, you know, elderly friends or people you know that have medical conditions, you need to protect them, and that means protecting yourself from illness too.
Have you all been able to figure out yet why Kershaw County is the area with the most cases so far?
We don't have a single identifiable cause. We have certainly looked into many different possibilities. We have done very thorough investigations. Our epidemiology team has been involved there since day one, you know, looking into anything and everything. But there's no one source, you know, so far. And so really at this point, we need to encourage the prevention strategies to, you know, prevent it from spreading more.
If there's one thing that we all can do today to make ourselves healthier, what would that be?
I think that at this point, avoiding crowds and avoiding contact with others is the biggest thing. And that include, there's different aspects of that. Then, of course, to include staying in, not going to work when you're sick, et cetera. But really, avoiding contact with other people, close contact, is the best strategy.